This idea started about 10 years ago when Oud, our group leader, first moved to ICFO.
It's actually quite old idea. We had this idea back in 2007, and it's an experiment that I wanted to do for a very long time. And so I'm very happy that it finally succeeded. Actually, I didn't think that it would succeed so fast. You know, one day I thought it would take much longer to do this. But one day, you know, my two people of my team, Dario and Samuele, came in my office and they say, oh, "Okay, we are ready to do the experiment." So this experiment is what we create, an entanglement between remote solid state quantum memories, is something that will be very important for realizing quantum repeaters. So what is a quantum repeater? It's a device that we can use to distribute quantum information over very long distances.
We, for the first time, successfully stored one single photon between two quantum memories that have now been placed at a distance. This is quite a landmark result that will be helpful in the development of quantum communication and eventually the quantum internet.
Hasta ahora, muchas cosas que hicimos nosotros se habían conseguido de forma individual. Se habían entrelazado memorias cuánticas, se habían almacenado fotones durante mucho tiempo con alta eficiencia y con altos ratios. Pero todas estas cosas juntas no se habían conseguido. En nuestro caso, las hemos entrelazado de una forma que es compatible con la red de telecomunicaciones que existe ahora mismo.
I think the most difficult part about this experiment was that we had to stabilize this system. What does this mean? The two memories were now placed at a distance. They were about 10 meters apart, but they were connected by 25 meters of optical fibers. This means that to demonstrate that we had entanglement, we had to stabilize the length of the two optical fibers with a precision of tens of nanometers. Before we actually stabilized the system, we could detect any type of vibrations, including, for example, the natural vibrations of the building itself, which is something that you will never perceive otherwise.
El marco teórico ya existía. Se conocía bien más o menos lo que se tenía que hacer. Lo que faltaba era hacerlo experimentalmente. Y necesitábamos una memoria cuántica capaz de almacenar durante bastante tiempo la luz, los fotones, y con suficiente eficiencia. Y después necesitábamos una fuente de fotones compatible con la memoria cuántica. Y una vez teníamos esas dos cosas, necesitábamos duplicar todo de forma que las fuentes de fotones crearan fotones indistinguibles con exactamente las mismas propiedades. Y nada, y una vez tuvimos todo, hicimos el experimento, que de hecho es uno de los principales resultados de mi tesis doctoral.
In the near future, one of the first applications is going to be centered that run quantum simulation for drug development. And once this simulation is run, the result will probably have to be sent to another center that, for example, runs quantum computation and runs quantum algorithms. Now, this connection can only be done with a quantum network. And this quantum network not only is the only way of achieving this transfer of information, but it's also a secure way of transferring information between these two parties.
So we have, actually, we want to go on towards the realization of a quantum repeater. And for this, the steps are quite clear. The first thing that we want to do is really to try to go to very long distances, both in the labs using optical fibers on spools, but also outside the lab. We want to bring this experiment outside the lab. And then after this, yeah, we want to go on and try to make a real functional quantum repeater link and to try to entangle different links together and to really progress towards being able to distribute entanglement over distances much longer than are possible without using this quantum repeater.
Como físico, a lo largo de todos nuestros años de formación, nos enseñan que la física clásica y la física cuántica no se llevan bien, que la física cuántica es antiintuitiva en muchos sentidos. Pero tú eso lo sabes porque te lo enseñan y te sabes la teoría, pero de ahí a llegar al laboratorio y haber medido y experimentado y visto los efectos del entrelazamiento y de la física cuántica y darte cuenta que realmente lo que pasa es antiintuitivo y de hecho poder controlarlo porque es un experimento que tú mismo has diseñado, es una pasada.